Greetings, children. Welcome to the online classes. Today we are going to learn lesson 26, ecosystem. We are going to continue with the same lesson. Already in this lesson we discussed about the structure, function and basic components of ecosystem. Today in this class we are going to learn factors affecting the stability of ecosystem. There are four major factors which affects the stability of ecosystem. They are productivity, decomposition, energy flow and nutrient cycling. We are going to learn about each and every factor in detail. The first factor which we are going to learn is productivity. Productivity generally means the produced biomass of an ecosystem. So how much amount of radiant energy, sunlight, is fixed in the producers, that is what productivity. It is a unit measurement, so this happens at a unit time in unit organisms, okay, in a particular defined organism in a definite time, how much amount of radiant energy is fixed. That is what the term productivity exactly means. So this is indirectly, it shows the production of how much biomass, how much weight an organism has gained, a plant has gained after a particular time, that shows how much productivity has been done by the organism, right? So this is what productivity. And in productivity we have two major classification. There is gross productivity and net productivity. You can see that gross productivity and net productivity. Gross productivity means total energy, how much radiant energy is being fixed in the organism, that is gross productivity. It shows a rough calculation of how much biomass has been added. And net productivity, if you want to know about net productivity, this is how much energy is being being used by the organism. There will be expenditure. If you reduce the expenditure from gross productivity, you will get net productivity. Can you understand that gross productivity is the total productivity of organism? Net productivity is after the expenditure, how much is being stored in that organism while it enters into the next trophic level. That is what net productivity. The major expenditure will be in organisms will be by respiration. When an organism is producing some amount of glucose, that is what we are talking about productivity or biomass. When an organism is producing some amount of glucose, this organism, for example, like a grass, okay, we are talking about a producer now. The gross productivity of that producer, for example, may be 100 gram per unit time, okay, for one grass per unit time, maybe for 1 month or for 1 year. So for unit time, how much biomass has been added into that organism, that is gross productivity. What is then net productivity? This organism, for its survival, this organism will be utilizing some amount of energy. By doing respiration, it will be spending that glucose for the production of ATP. So that respiration will be done, that's a process, expenditure process. So this organism will be utilizing some amount of energy by a process called respiration. And apart from that, for movement it will be utilizing, and for reproduction, for growth, for development. These are all the expenditure, but respiration is the major process where you can calculate an amount of expenditure. The other processes are like very less amount, and they are also deriving energy through respiration only. So respiration is the major process by which the energy is being spent, and the rest will be stored in that organism as net productivity. And this net productivity is what entering into the next trophic level. Okay, so that is what productivity, gross productivity and net productivity. While you are talking about productivity of producer, we are using a word primary productivity there. So if you are talking about a producer's productivity, that is gross primary productivity or net primary productivity, which deals about the producer's energy. And when in case of secondary productivity, this comes under the consumer's productivity. When you are talking about the productivity of an animal, how much amount of glycogen has been stored in that animal, that is secondary productivity. That can be secondary, gross secondary productivity or net secondary productivity. If a grass is being eaten by a herbivore, the herbivore will gain the net primary productivity of the grass, right? The herbivore will get or gain net primary productivity of grass, which will be utilized by the organism. It will be accumulated into the cells of that organism. So at that time, you have to call that as a secondary gross productivity. Later, this herbivore will be spending some amount of energy through the process respiration, or for its locomotion. Animals will spend more energy in locomotion too. So locomotion, and then by digestion, and then for their growth, development, reproduction, all those processes, they are expenditure process. And what is being stored as glycogen for the rest or for the future is known as net secondary productivity in that animal. So secondary word always denotes the productivity level which we can find in consumers, and the primary productivity is the word which we can combine with producers. So there is a calculation that you need to know. Just you need to know the formula or this rough thing, right? Gross primary productivity is equal to net primary productivity plus respiration. So only this you need to know. So here in productivity, we discussed about what is productivity. Productivity is the amount of biomass or amount of radiant energy which is fixed in the organism, in the producer organism, or amount of biomass which is produced in a consumer or in a carnivore or herbivore, in a consumer level organism. So that is what productivity. Productivity can be gross productivity or net productivity. Gross is the first which is being accumulated in an organism. Net productivity is the one which enters into the next trophic level. The major source of expenditure is by respiration. And when in case of producer, we are discussing about primary productivity. When in case of consumer, it is about secondary productivity. That's it about productivity. The next factor is decomposition.